Welcome to the Everyday Mom Challenge. This is for all of my people that are in their dissertation process right now, or they're just starting their doctorate program and they kind of want to know where to begin. We're now on K. This is part three of our series. So go back and check out the R, the O, and the C. This is really important that you ask yourself these questions. The K is, do you know what it takes? The hours of research and the commitment that you're going to do with this, it is phenomenal. And I really wish that I would have documented the hours. I do have my references documented, which are like over 300 reference articles that I use for my dissertation work and study, not to mention the positive psychology books that I read and all of the videos that I watched. I mean, if you calculate the time spent, it is just astronomical. So I want to let you know right now, when you do this work, if you need to find the gaps early, that's the first thing you do. Because if you don't, and you just start doing just random research, you're going to waste a lot of time. So let me talk with you about early on. I told you that I tried the prison ministry. I was told access would be difficult because I didn't have connections. So I dropped that idea. Then I went to homeschool ideas and religious practices. I was going to wonder if it would, if I could find research about that, just because that's my life and I knew I had connections with homeschool and families. So, and for homeschool organizations. But when I started doing the research on it, I couldn't find enough gaps. I couldn't find enough articles. So I had to abandon that idea. Oops, see? Yep. There's another. Thanks for the video. Okay, good, guys. I'm glad you guys are watching the videos, and I'm hoping that it's going to help. But I want to say the commitment that it takes early on is going to pay off because you won't waste time. So if you want to look at leadership styles, that's very broad, for example. But you better find gaps specific to your original idea that can help support your work. It can't just be in an area where you're not going to get a lot of support, because then you're wasting your time later. So be very smart about it at the beginning stages. I will tell you this, the resourcefulness that you do at the very beginning will pay off. So after you have found your 5 to 7 articles that support your gap, the more gap articles you can find, the better, in case the dates run out, if you do have a time limit, jump right on YouTube. Now, I created a private YouTube playlist. I love YouTube. I did a statistics one where I taught myself statistics on qualitative and quantitative research. I chose quantitative. But I didn't know at the beginning which way I was going to go. I kind of sat on the fence for that for a while until I knew quantitative was my best avenue for my data collection. But I also started emailing professors. Start doing that early. Start making connections early. You don't get them to sign waivers. You don't get them to sign that they're going to be a part of your research. That's not what you're doing. That only comes after your IRB is approved, and you do not need to take those routes. When I say start making connections, you need to start taking your research that you're working on and start connecting it to other platforms. What's going on in YouTube? What's going on at universities? So that way you can just increase your knowledge base about your topic. Go ahead and build your organization early. I really wish that I would have started a reference page early on. I had to do Google Sheets for my reference page because I had to turn that in as a part of my committee work. But I really wish I would have started my reference page earlier on. Think of some organization tips that you can do. You can go on and build your chapters, build your folders for your chapters. If you have your theoretical frameworks that you're working on, go ahead and build those folders. So that way, when you're researching, and for example, I use the PERMA model in positive psychology. Every article that I found with the PERMA model, I threw it under a PERMA model folder. That way that when I started to discuss the model and that theoretical framework piece, the conceptual frameworks, I was able to go straight to that Google Drive folder. My research was already there. And I was just able to hit next, and refresh because I'd already read them, but I had to refresh and constantly refresh. I'm going to tell you now, resilience is key. K for key, it's key. You do not allow the setbacks that you face to stop your momentum because you can quickly get depressed. You can quickly have drawbacks, and then you'll sit and you'll get like paralyzed. You can't move through it. You can get writer's block. You've got to be very careful because every time you get through those valleys, time continues to click and tick away. It just keeps moving. When you get a setback, you have to understand that that's your learning start stage. That's a part where you learn. That's the part where you grow. And you pick yourself back up. You surround yourself by collaborative people. You get help. And you move forward. Because you got to have a tough skin for critique. And I will tell you, my AQR process was absolutely brutal. It was brutal. It was tearing apart my work to the bones. And I am so grateful for it. And I have a very tough skin for being able to receive constructive feedback because I understand that I am not perfect. I understand my weaknesses. That's why I purchased Grammarly. I did not need an editor because of that. What I did need is somebody to really challenge my way that I presented and organize my work, my sentences. Was the research, was the evidence strong enough? Did this support claims that I was making? The work that was put into my critique was phenomenal. And I am so appreciative of my content expert who graduated from the university, from New York University. I mean, just amazing feedback that I received, even though it hurt like hello to receive all of that. It hurt only for a moment. I brushed myself off, and that's where the resiliency kicks in because you cannot stop. You have to take it as you're learning, as that this is a part of it. And then you collaborate with other people and you seek help. And that's what I love about my life coaching business is because so many people, they know me from residency. They know me from classes and posts, and just they know me through Facebook. And they're in their programs and they're reaching out to me. And, you know, one of the learners, he just graduated. And we need to help each other. So contact me if you need help through Monarch Educational Services. But just get the courage that you need because this is a long, arduous journey. It's very specialized. You have to build your skill set. But you also need to create your vision. There's a lot of YouTube videos out there about vision boards and doing that. And I do say that that's a part of our positive psychology is that you really need a statement, our why. I do a lot of the our why work because I think that that's so important because that really fuels our passion. But I would also encourage you to find a Bible verse. And I found a Bible verse that fit my dissertation topic, my work. It just encompassed everything. The whole work just fit into this verse. And not only did I put it into my dedication in my dissertation, it was in my last pages of my dissertation, but it really stayed with me. And when I would get discouraged, I would say, you know, God, you know, I'm doing this for you. But give me my why again. I need to see it. And that Bible verse would really help encourage me and push me forward. So please, I just encourage you to do a vision statement. Find your Bible verses. Take some time to just separate yourself from the work for a few minutes, a day or two, and really spend time in prayer. And build yourself up. Seek help. Work with those around you. Start putting the tools in place. Be resourceful. Watch tons of YouTube. Do hours upon hours upon hours of your research and your confidence will grow. Look, this is a long-term commitment. This is a part of your life's story. So I hope that this series has helped you. And if you need me, let me know. Good luck to you. I'm praying for you.